So now let's consider a BOM problem with lead time consideration. So this problem is included in the D2L course website. Let's consider product A, which is end item. And this product A consists of different parts and components. So this is similar to the previous problems. But now we consider lead times. So these are the lead time information, you know, starting with A all the way to subcomponents F. Then demand requirement for item A is 50 units in day 10. So suppose that customers, they require the 50 units in day 10. So you have to really produce the 50 units of end item A in day 10. So in order to fulfill these 50 units of end item A, we have to calculate how many components and parts are required and when to order. So this should be done. So you can draw this BOM, which is product structure tree, based on this information. And also, based on the lead time information and demand requirement, let's consider how to calculate these components and subcomponents. So day 10, 50 units of A is required. So we have to place order in 9th day, because of the 1 day lead time. Now, in order to release A, to place order in 9th day, consider how much B should be ordered. B, we need 4 B's for each A, so B equals the 4A. So 4 times 50, which is 200 units of B, are required in order to place order of A in 9th day. And this 200 units of B should be ordered in 7th day because of 2 day lead time. And similarly, you can calculate the C all the way to F. So let's consider how to calculate these, you know, components. So in order to release A, we need B's and C's. These components B and C are required. So B equals 4A and C equals 2A. So 4 times 50 is the 200 unit of B, and 2 times A, which is 50, so 100 unit of C are required. So 200 unit B and 100 C should be there in order to place order of 50 units of A in 9th day. These numbers should be ordered in 2 days advance and 1 day advance because of lead time for B and lead time for C. Now, in order to release B, we need a component of D and E. So 200 units of B should before you placing order of 200 units of B in 7th day, we needed, you know, D 2 times B, which is 2 times 200, which is 400 units of D, and 1 E equals 1 B, so 1 times 200, 200 units of E. And this should be ordered in 3 days advance and 4 days advance. And finally, in order to release C, here, we need 3C of D and then 2C of F. So 300 units of D and 200 units of F. Again, the order placement should be done in 3 days in advance and 1 day in advance. That way you can calculate and order each component and part and subpart component in the timely manner, so that ultimately you can fulfill the 50 unit of A in day 10. So as you can see, if you consider lead time, then things become much more complex. And this is the basis of calculating MRP explosion problems, which I can explain in the next video lecture. Thank you.